here with our November predictions. Yep, November is upon us. I'm concentrating. I've been led to use the Earth Alchemy deck to aid my predictions this month. So I will be pulling several cards out. I am playing some Native American flute music, which is available on YouTube in the background. A bit of ambience. Well, I shuffle the deck. My eyes are closed. I've already said the prayer and rang the bell. And I'm working with Archangel Michael and Uriel at this moment in time. We have Mama Kako and Rhoda Knight. This is asking us to open our hearts. And around during November, we're going to be heightened, have a bit of heightened sensitivity. But I'm being told that this is the A card. This is the America card. Although there is a bit of heightened sensitivity around America during November time, you will be feeling unified and you will be feeling quite loved. And that is the only high you will be needing to feel at that time, as it is election season. Many Americans will be feeling that they are going to get their true desire, their heart's desire in their leader. The next card is Crazy Lace and Agate and Sunflower. This is to say there's more fun time and jokes and laughter ahead, please. So let's hope you are getting Mr. Trump, because this will enable you all to move forward with a bit of playfulness, a bit of love and laughter, which is what you need after the austerity that you've suffered of late. Over at the UK now. The UK, we have the Green Man and Moss Agate. This is all about ritual and ceremony and new spirit guides and true wisdom. We need to watch out for those who have been a bit more ritualistic around our parliament, and they are trapping people in who don't need to be trapped. They are robbing Peter to pay Paul, and they're playing with people's lives. I see the big stop sign. They need to stop. The next card is the Stromatolite. Or Stromatolite and Fern. This is the Akasha or the Akashic Records. The Akashic Records are opening and they're being told to strip back and simplify and look at our origins. We need to look and work with our ancestors. Those who know how to do this, please do this in your meditations. Rose quartz and the olive tree. The olive branch of peace is going to be handed out. Compassion and the Venus energy is going to be evident here at this time. So this will happen smoothly. And going to say this. With the rose quartz, you've also got camellia or carnations, whatever. And the olive branch, we need peace. We need peace in war-torn areas. This is the time of peace and reflection. We can only have peace if the person who knows how to bring it and knows how to broker it gets into office, the right man for the job. And I'm saying the man for the job. Okay. I see more unrest. Quite tribal conflicts, not native tribal. It's like tribes going to war. Hear engines roaring. So this could be biker warfare. Over territory. Woe betide anyone who gets in their way. I also have another stop sign coming up. It's like the hand saying stop, stop. This hand is saying stop for a reason. It's asking everyone to stop and reflect on their actions. Take a deep breath, a pause for a moment. Do this regularly. It is time for you to reflect. There is an American football player going to reveal some painful issue. Built like a bloody mountain. He said, but I wasn't myself when this happened. I was not myself. I was under a spell, under something or under a spell. Just watch for that. Lewis Hamilton. Is going to reveal something that will rock the F1 world. Even more than it has been rocked in the last few years. That deck of cards is going to fall. More stars will fall from grace. wasn't just Diddy who was obsessed with any royal family. It wasn't just the British royal family he was obsessed with. And this other person, they were obsessed with multiple royal families. Where the eagles fly, where the herons land, there will be a revelation. And children will be found. Stop blaming each other. And let the earth tilt back onto the axis it's supposed to be on. By the winter solstice, there will be a confirmed sighting of a missing star, and I don't mean a twinkling one, a missing star who's been missing for quite a while from the sea. Milo, please. Here, time for a fairy oracle. The fairies are asking you to look in a book. Whatever your question right now, you'll find the answer in a book. The words you find will bring the insight you seek. So if you've been looking for answers in your ancestry, you will find them in a book of photographs, maybe in an old diary written somewhere that people have been thought they'd long forgotten about. Yeah. cold as night, as warm as day. Go out and let the children play. When the eve begins to fall, bring them in. It's time to rest. Keep them safe as they are the future. Nurture their innocence and nurture their souls, as they are no longer children for but a while. Let them grow and let them see. Let them journey through their lives at their will. Guide them. Don't push them. Their life's lessons are theirs to learn alone. They come to you when they need your guidance. Moderation is the last card from the fairy's wisdom. Is there something you know that you shouldn't be eating? Try to eat mindfully and healthily. Though the fairies say a little bit of what you fancy is fine. Some more fruit and vegetables if you can. I know it's a time of austerity. A time of make do and mend still. And sorry UK, we've still got to rob Peter to pay Paul. I keep saying that for years, but unfortunately it is the truth for a while longer yet, because pension pots are going to be raided by the government. They're still not going to tax the mega rich. They're going to heavily tax the poorer instead. The poor who are striving and barely surviving. And this includes the working poor. I do see the world's economy taking a dip just before the inauguration. I see something happen in Saudi. King's daughter. Beautiful princess. I'm sure she's going to be married again in secret. Yes, she is. I've got the Seer's Crystal card. The Seer's Crystal is the all-seeing eyes. Clarity and focus and divination. She is saying, this card is saying that she's been married again. She'd been married in secret. Her ex-husband's not happy about it because he thought she would take him back. But she doesn't like cheats. Cheats never prosper. He was banished from his homeland. This marriage is a love marriage. Marriage made in heaven, the sacred chalice says so, and it's bringing abundance to her and our fulfilling life. It's bringing nourishment. This is a very nourishing feeling she's going through right now. King Abdullah has issues with his health. Although there is a mystery surrounding him, there is issues with his health. The sons are doing more work. Behind the scenes. But there is an unexpected encounter coming their way as well. European royal family, Danish royal family. It's going to be a big scandal pertaining to the Danish royal family. But he'll find his way out of it. He's got the key. The key will unlock things to bring some peace to his family. The scandal may also bring the divorce that's wanted. I've got Madonna going to have a major health scare this year, towards January. Yep, the zodiac circle, astrological influences. She's a very big believer in the astrological guidance, and she is working now to find out how she can forego this, but she can't. It's all in the planets. It's all in alignment. And it's coming her way. There's going to be a bit of upheaval in Romania towards the back end of November, beginning of December. The winter solstice. I've already mentioned that once tonight. There's also going to be volcanic activity in Italy, Iceland. Possibly Portugal. Hawaii is always rumbling, but could be also in Hawaii. This is just Mother Earth resetting, rebirthing, and telling us to pause and reflect. You'll notice it's going to happen because the animals will start moving and migrating. Animals are great tellers of time and weather patterns. And unfortunately, that'll spark off some more wacky hurricanes, tornadoes in areas which don't normally suffer them. So for the Scots amongst us, Donald will be looking for his trousers, because he'd not be wanting to wear that blinking kilt. And then the Falcon's flight. We'll have the freedom and the aspirations. This card also pertains to the American election. But there's also a bit of unrest within the British government. There's somebody vying. They've got aspirations and ideas of grandeur. And they're already pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing. Because they want to get up those steps. They're wanting to be up these steps here. They're at the bottom, but they want to be at the top. They want to be wearing that crown of light that this Falcon's wearing. Yes, at the moment they've got the head in the clouds. They're so far up their own rear ends. It's unbelievable. But to be able to get this crown of fabulous white light, they're going to start pushing people out of the way. And you'd be surprised, I've been told, it's not Angela Rayner. It's someone else. Says you'd be surprised to see who it is. So I'm going to leave my November predictions here. And bid you adieu. And I will see you on the next predictions for December. This one was a little bit different, I know. But I'm eating my trans now. So bye. And I'll see you on the live shows.